better place. Can't you see that we must live life a different way? Every day, imagine what love could turn this to. Wanna change the world, then change your mind. We'll light the darkness one life at a time. When we change,
welcome to the first ever Emily Summers Show. My name is Emily Summers. I just graduated from high school and I will be attending MCC in the fall. I have a really strong passion for helping others, and during high school is when I developed my passion because I heard stories about what other people have to deal with in life, and it absolutely changed my life because it taught me that I need to accept everyone because you never know what someone else goes through. And it also taught me just to you that you can make a difference in someone's life. So that's exactly why I want to have this show, is because I want to show you guys what others have to deal with in life, and I hope that this show will teach you that you can make a difference in someone's life, in our community, and in this world, and show you the importance of accepting everyone and being kind. So I thought a long time about what I wanted my first show to be about, and I couldn't come up with anything better than to talk about the importance of teachers. I believe that teachers have one of the most important jobs in our world. They are educating every other profession. They are the ones who are making a huge difference. And so today we will be showcasing two teachers who go above and beyond to show their students that they care, to build relationships with their students, and they make a difference. The first guest that was supposed to be on here but wasn't able to was Mrs. Hannah. She's a teacher at Muscatine High School, and she had something really important come up, so she wasn't able to make it today. But we have a video for her to show her exactly how much people appreciate her and how she has made such a huge difference. So here is that video. When students are in Mrs. Hannah's classroom, it's like a second family. They feel comfortable to be themselves, answer questions, and say their opinions.
Striving for success.
Like, yeah. You have a good head on your shoulders.
And you're obviously okay, really organized. And
organized. Like, I'm like planning ahead. Yeah, perfect. Okay, really good.
That's a I'm going to put that on my face.
That is a brilliant idea.
Mrs. Hannah brings her students up by giving them compliments and by making them feel good about who they are.
Wait, what I really want to know, I'm not even so much worried about the... Did you get your face cut?
Yeah, I got my hair color too.
Cute.
It's perfect.
I know.
It's really good. Sorry, I don't know where. It looks really cute.
She inspires people to reach for more than what they think is even possible.
My name is Andy Princeton. I teach U.S. government with the G Squared group, and I get to do a lot of team teaching with Mrs. Hannah. It's been an awesome experience and a real pleasure on my part. Watching her come in every day, sometimes having spent half her night working on things for her students. It's an inspiration. Sometimes it's even to the point of being intimidating because trying to live up to the standards that she sets as a teacher at this school is a challenge every day and keeps me and I think a lot of her colleagues trying to put their best foot forward.
Hannah was an awesome teacher. She was very inspiring, so it made it really easy to learn in her class.
Is a really important person to me in my life. Like, I've told her a lot of stuff that I couldn't normally confide in anyone else of. She's really helped me kind of a lot this year, just expand like my thoughts and grow into the person that I am.
She taught, and her teaching style was awesome. Like, I learned a lot.
She's really inspired me to be the best person that I can be and strive for my goals, not mattering who or what gets in the way, and just to continue and follow through. And she's never hesitant to help anybody, and she always strives to be the best person that she can be and help others in whatever way she can. And she's done so much for me, and I've really grown to be able to trust her and look to her for anything that I need for advice or whatever. And she's awesome, and I really love her. Love you, Miss Hannah.
To me, Ms. Hannah is a really good teacher because she's not like other teachers. She's really understanding about like personal problems and stuff. She's someone that you can go to with anything, and she won't judge you, and she'll listen to you, give you advice and stuff. And it's really helpful to have a teacher like that because it's nice to have an adult besides a parent that you can talk to and that helps you. and she's a really fun teacher too. Mrs. Hina has made a difference in my life because she's someone that I can talk to about anything, and she helps me with all of my problems.
She's really, really encouraging because, like, the most, like, the students that you never expect to say anything will come up with the most, like, brilliant things. And I don't know, she's changed my point of view on my future, because before I wanted to do fashion design, and she always encouraged that too, but, like, the stuff that she taught this year had, like, kind of opened my eyes to help people more or, like, do something more productive with my life. And I think that she's done that with a lot of students.
Well, Mrs. Hannah, she's one of the few teachers that not only do they teach from the book, but they actually teach from the heart. Like, they go far and beyond what their job requirements are. Like, I had her my sophomore year and junior year, and in those 2 years, she completely turned my life around. I didn't expect any teacher to do that for me. Since English is my second language, I didn't really expect to challenge myself in that area. And she told me to take her AP language course. And I kind of doubted myself because I didn't think I could do it. But she really challenged me and told me to go over what I was expected to do. And I feel like she really was looking out for me. And especially this year, she's helped me a lot, writing letters of recommendation for me, for colleges and things like that.
When I first met Mrs. Hannah at Davenport Central, it was actually my students that had told me that I needed to go down and meet this really cool teacher who was doing some really amazing things. And whether when we were at Davenport Central or since we've come here to Muscatine, she's always had a very unique way of communicating to her students and pulling the best out of them. And seeing my wife work with her students, it's what I, you know, try to aspire to be as a teacher. It's what I, try to do. I am a better teacher for knowing her. I'm a better teacher for being married to her.
Everyone who knows Mrs. Hannah will go farther in life, be more confident, and help others along the way. She is a caring, compassionate, courageous woman who has made a difference in so many students' lives. Mrs. Hannah, thank you so much for caring. And you have made such a huge difference in people's lives. So I just want to say thank you from all of us students. Now with us today, we have Mike Fladlien, which is known as Flad. And he is a teacher who's making a huge difference at Muscatine High School. He teaches economics, and he's actually been teaching for 31 years. So thank you so much for being here today, Flad.
Thank you for having me on the show, Emily.
So you've actually been teaching for 31 years. Did someone inspire you to become a teacher, or where did the inspiration come from?
I've had so many great teachers in my life. I think it started when I was in high school. I had a shorthand teacher mm-hmm. who could just push us so hard to learn Greek shorthand that when I got done, I needed a nap. I was so tired. And I said, if I ever was going to be a business teacher, I'd want to be like Mrs. Brown, and her maiden name was Hall. And then my wrestling coach was outstanding too. Frank Freeman was a great wrestler in his time. He was second in the nation a couple of times and second in the Olympic trials.
Wow.
And I learned so much from Frank. If we have time, I'd like to just share one story about him and how he's made a difference in my life.
You can do that right now if you want.
Okay, well, Frank always wanted to be a millionaire. And I can remember one time in the locker room, he was telling everybody, yeah, I'm a millionaire. And, and so we watched Frank grow. And then he invested heavily in real estate. And in about 1988, something happened in the real estate market where Frank literally lost everything.
Wow.
And when I ran into him one time, Frank says to me, you know, Flat, people think I'm down and out, but I'll be back. And you wait and see. And that year he took his team to the state duels and got second in the state
wow.
duel tournament. And he has indeed recovered all he lost. If you've ever seen Freeman's Tree Farm on 53rd Street in Davenport, you know what I mean.
That's amazing. That just shows that you can't give up. No matter how far you are down, you can always fight your way back up and get it all back.
And I think we all are going to have something like that happen, a major right. setback in our life where we want to quit and we want to, you know, pack it in. And I always think back of how much Frank made a difference in my life.
That's awesome. And I'm so glad that those people did make a difference in your life, because now you're able to make a difference in other people's lives too.
You know, another teacher that made a huge difference in my life was Gary Hirsch. Mm-hmm. I couldn't pass algebra, and I was in summer school, and I wasn't doing very well, and I got really sick. In fact, I had to be hospitalized. Mm-hmm. And Gary showed up, and I think there was no place for me to run then. And at my hospital, in the hospital, Gary spent weeks with me teaching me algebra.
That's awesome.
You know, I think what other teacher would go the extra mile like that?
And that's what teachers have to do, you know, and you do that too. So your passion is teaching economics. You can see it in your eyes when you're teaching about it. How did you know that that's what you were supposed to be teaching, and how did you know that that was your passion?
Well, like I said, originally I wanted to be a shorthand teacher and a typing teacher, but one day, Beth Hetzler comes up to me and says to me, you know, Flad, you're the only one certified to teach economics, so why don't you try to teach it?
Wow.
And so I thought, you know, I'm the man, I could do this. And so I went and I got the textbook, and I opened up the front page, and literally I couldn't read the front page, the first page in that book. Mm-hmm. I said, oh my God, what have I gotten myself into? I can't do the math. I don't understand the language of this. I'm going to have to work really, really, really hard. But it seemed to have a lot of, I don't know, it seemed to make sense to me.
Mm-hmm.
And things before that I didn't understand started to come together. So it provided me with a rational decision-making process. And I thank Mrs. Hetzler for that.
Yeah.
Many a times for forcing me to do something. And again, a teacher forcing me to do something I really didn't want to do.
Yeah, you went out of your comfort zone, but then you realized that that's what you were supposed to be doing.
And I think for me, economics is that metaphor for life.
Mm-hmm.
You know, are you going to do what you always do and get what you've always got? Are you going to try to extend yourself and push beyond compromise and try to see what you're really made out of?
Right, that's awesome.
And I think that's what economics really represents to me. It's, again, algebra comes back, and I have to keep learning and learning and pushing myself. And that's what economics represents for me, I think, is some kind of struggle.
Yeah. Well, it's awesome what you've done with that. And we actually have a video for you that we want you to watch. And it's a good surprise for you. But we just want you to know how much you're appreciated and how you have made such a huge difference, Vlad. So here is that video. Vlad teaches his students life lessons.
On my way to the restroom, there's a person, I don't even know their name. I just say, hey. They go, hey. How many of you have a hey guy? Somebody that you don't know their name, but you just want to say, hey. So if you don't have a hey guy, get one. It'll make your life a little bit more fulfilled. Okay.
He shows them the importance of being kind and compassionate to all people. He teaches from his heart, and he uses real life examples to make learning relatable to all of his students.
Vlad changed my life because Vlad nominated me for the Excellence in Education Award, and Vlad was the only one that knew anything about my life, so he was the only one that could recommend me for it. And it really meant a lot to me that Vlad took the time and the effort to do this for me.
Vlad teaches in a way I've never learned before. He tells stories about econ that relates to everyday life. And he always teaches class in a no-nonsense way, and I really like that.
I mean, Vlad's a great guy. He is extremely supportive. He cares a ton about the people he helps and teaches. And he helps others reach their dreams. Recently, I've looked into developing a mobile application for cell phones, smartphones, things like that. I knew that Vlad had already developed one. And so I went to him for advice, and he helped me through the steps, like step by step, through the process. And he supported me 100%, and now my app is on the market.
Vlad has been my homeroom teacher for the last 3 years. We love him because he's always interested in what we're doing and gives us crazy feedback.
Vlad has made a very positive influence on my life because he made me really show my true colors for my love of business, and so that's what I'm going to college for, so I have him to thank. And he has been a great role model in his teaching because he taught me all I needed to know about microeconomics, and I passed the college class at a 98%, so that shows his level of intelligence.
I think Fladlien's an amazing speaker. A lot of the things he says are very inspirational and help a lot of the students to overcome a lot of things or even get inspired for many things.
I haven't had him for an actual class, but I've had him for homeroom for freshmen, sophomore and junior years. He always instigates really good conversation and challenges what you think, but never in a way that is like trying to prove you wrong or make you feel like you don't know what you're talking about.
He's a really nice guy. I've never really had him as a teacher, but I met him a couple times, and very kind and generous person. I like what he's doing with Rachel's challenge.
He's such a good teacher because he like makes you work harder. Like not by telling you you have to, but just by like encouraging you, by challenging you, and he never makes you feel like you can't do what you want to, and he thinks bigger than most people do, I think, and he lets you know that just because you're in high school now doesn't mean that you can be bigger and better than everything that's around you.
Vlad is a man on a mission. He always talks to me about the MAD acronym, Make a Difference. He is embedded in me, in my brain, that if you haven't made a difference, if you go to bed without making a difference or making the world a better place, you've almost wasted the day, and that you're not doing your job as a member of society. So Flad, thanks for making me a better man, and thanks for doing what you do.
When students talk about Flad, their faces always light up, and you can tell every single one of them knows how much he cares. Flad has touched more people's lives than he will ever even know. Students respect him, students look up to him, and students hope to be like him someday. He is a man of strength, courage, and love. He has changed so many students' lives, and he will always be remembered as someone who cared.
Vlad, it is so amazing how many lives you have touched. It really is. I could have went up to like anyone in the high school and made a super long video for you to just show you what everyone thinks about you. Every person I went up to, they had something that they wanted to say. They had been inspired by you in some way, which is awesome.
Well, that video was very sweet. I'm honored that all those people would say all those things. I think what came to mind to me was, if you want something bad enough, the way to get it is to help somebody else achieve what they want to achieve. And like with Josh Wheaton, he helped me put another app on the market. And so we both got better. By me helping him, I also got better as well. And Rachel's challenge has been a real growth area for me, and I thank you for that.
Yep.
The kindness and the sharing of everything that you do really does make a difference.
Right, absolutely. And you're able to connect with students so well and relate with them. How do you think you're able to do that?
Well, I don't think I have a real dominant personality, and so I'm prone to listen to people.
Right.
And I think people really want somebody that will really listen mm-hmm. to them. And I try to really listen to what they're saying.
Yes.
And then in some way work it into my daily activities. So if some kid is talking about, like, I don't know, like an example I had was this kid was talking about Kid Rock all the time mm-hmm. and how he liked it. And so I was looking through an issue of Rolling Stone magazine and found an article on Kid Rock, and I brought it to him.
Right.
And I think that's the kind of listening that people like, and not just students, but everyone.
Absolutely, for sure. Listening's very important. That's how you really do make a difference, is if you listen to someone and you care enough to listen. So what is the hardest thing that you've ever gone through that helps you to connect and relate with students in a way if they're going through the same situation?
Well, that's a pretty open-ended question. I wasn't the best learner in high school. I really graduated towards the bottom of my class.
Right.
And I'm not a really strong personality, so teachers would always help somebody else before they would help me.
Mm-hmm.
And so one of the things that I try to do in class is I try to help every kid.
Yeah. Right.
And I'll walk by him, I'll say, hey, you know, let me check that, or let me see that workbook, and I'll grab it and check it right there. That way, every kid gets an interaction in my class, and every kid gets a chance to interact with me.
Right.
And I think that's the best thing I do. I don't really think that I'm brilliant or I have anything special. It's just that I'm special to kids.
Yes.
Because I do care that they
right.
learn.
Exactly, so important.
That one thing, that caring, I think is all that matters.
Absolutely. So you said, like in what Nate said about you, is that you teach your students that you can make a difference and that you wake up mad every morning, which means you're gonna make a difference. So how long have you been doing that for?
Well, it started when Chuck Van Heck was the AD at the high school, mm-hmm. he would say, Flad, you gotta be ready every day. Somebody's gonna need you.
Right.
And you wake up in the morning and you say to yourself, oh man, it's only Tuesday. And I gotta do this and this and this and this. But when you change it, when you reframe what you think in the morning to somebody's gonna need you that day,
right.
it gives you a whole nother purpose. You walk faster and you wanna make a difference. So when I get those four or five kids that walk in, hey, you got a minute to talk to me, then I know why I'm at work.
Right, that's awesome. So you are the Rachel's Challenge Advisor, and every single week we have absolutely amazing talks about just about people, about life, and just about making a difference. What do you think that one person, like that if every person in our community did, what could make a difference in our community?
I'd like to, next year with Rachel's Challenge, I'd like to start something I call a thank you project, mm-hmm. where when somebody does something for you, you just simply say thank you.
Right.
And I think that recognizes that person's actions, it validates their actions, so it makes it more likely to reoccur. Mm-hmm. And it's not like you're taking somebody for granted. I just think that people don't say thank you enough.
Yeah, and some people don't even know exactly how powerful saying thank you is, how it makes that person want to do what they did again and be more kind and stuff like that.
Yeah, I think sometimes, you walk by people and they give off that negative air, or they're cold to you, mm-hmm. Simply because they've tried so many times to do something and people haven't recognized it, or they haven't said thank you. I'd really like to see that as the major project next year.
Yeah, I think that sounds like a great idea.
I think that'd be more contagious than just about anything, and mm-hmm. it's so easy to spread, so
yes.
It wouldn't take much of a person's time or effort.
Right, and just like the chain reaction, like if you say thank you, then maybe they'll start saying thank you again, so it will pass around very fast. So
I believe that allows people to be more tolerant of diversity too.
Right, yep.
You've always said that, put yourself in the other person's shoes. Mm-hmm. I didn't know that you also had that same problem as I do, but when you say thank you to somebody, that means that they're thinking something the same
right.
as you.
Yep.
Whether it's opening a door or picking up a pencil for you, but it's putting you together. It's like making you see things from their point of view, which I think is very powerful.
I agree. So you have a podium in your classroom that's all signed by all of your students, which is really cool. And it just shows your students that you do care. How powerful do you think, and why do you think teachers should care about their students?
Well, I think it's one thing to coldly walk to a kid's paper and grade it and say, hey, you missed this, or you missed mm-hmm. this, or you didn't do this right, or something like that. And they're just gonna say, okay, But I think real learning is so much more powerful than just what did you do right and what did you do wrong. I think it's that connection with the person that makes you want to learn.
Right.
I don't know how many times has somebody told you that something was wrong, but until you experienced it yourself, you didn't change your behavior. Mm-hmm. Well, as a teacher, I would like them to know that I have the same feelings that they have because I've experienced it with them.
Right.
It's kind of like, I feel your pain type
right,
thing.
Right, yep.
I think it makes such a difference, though.
Uh-huh, I agree.
And, I go back to grading on that a lot. Mm-hmm. If all I care about is finding how many things wrong that you have and then dividing by the number possible to come up with a percent, I think I'm not teaching. Instead, I should be saying, okay, so you missed 10 of them. Let's now fix those 10 so you
Absolutely.
Get 100% right.
So they know what mistake they made so they can fix it for next time.
And it's more than that. It shows growth. I believe mm-hmm. people will continue to learn if they see growth in their work.
Right.
And how many times have I had to relearn the same thing a million times? So a person misses the same thing 50 or 60 times. As long as you care enough about them, I think it makes a difference.
I agree, for sure. It makes a big difference. So you're, as a teacher, what do you think your job is? Everyone probably has different opinions on this, but what do you believe that your job is as a teacher?
Well, I'd like to think I'm the major content provider, that I go there and people are going to learn from me, but really Google can replace me anymore.
No.
Again, I look back at Frank Freeman. You know, what Frank did for me was he called up the UNI and he got me a college scholarship there. A teacher can do that.
Right.
Google can't do that. And
exactly.
Like Paris White's very touching video that she, in the previous thing, you know, I think that's my role. I always try to say, I'm a bridge. I'm going to help you get from here to there along the way. And you might trample on me a little bit, and you know, I might not be able to teach everything I know, but I'm going to help you get from there to, from here to there. And I really think that's my job anymore, is to help kids get something more out of life.
Yeah, and that's what makes you such a great teacher. It really is because you care enough to want to help them go with a scholarship to college or anything like that. You go above and beyond to show them how much you care. And it's more than just sitting in the classroom and teaching them, but it's what are they doing in their life? How can I help them get farther in life?
Yeah, I think that's so important. I mean, like, yeah, your parents are great, but there's things that a teacher can do that nobody else can do. We have so many different connections and so many powerful resources, and there's so many good teachers at the high school that I think that one of the things, you know, a secondary teacher like myself just can't take himself too seriously, you know. You know, we work with kids, they're learning, they're going to make a lot of mistakes. So let's help them get to the next level and grow a little bit.
Yep. So you are an absolute believer. You really are. You believe that you can do anything in life. That's something that I have learned from you, and I think so many other students. How did you know that anything is possible in life, and how do you teach kids to believe in themselves?
Again, I'm going to say I just had really, really, really great wrestling coaches. You know, I've stepped on the mat with some world champions, and I've met people like Ben Peterson, who is an Olympic gold medalist and a runner-up, and these men have all inspired me. When I think that I can do anything, I have to say within reason, because I don't think I'll ever win the Nobel Prize or anything like that. But for me to do anything is to be the best that I can be. That's the way I understand it. And so when I wake up in the morning, yeah, I want to be mad, and I want to make a difference and all that stuff, you know, I'm not a Mother Teresa or I'm not a pope or anything like that, but I can make a huge difference in people's lives. And if I do that, then I'm thinking I'm being the best that I can be.
Right. Absolutely. If you make the environment that you're in the best it can be and reach out to people and make a difference, that makes a huge difference.
You know, the thing that I just talked about that really makes a big difference for me, and I learned it from Sean Covey, was you just don't compare yourself to other people. Mm-hmm. When you do that, you'll go crazy. Because
right, yep.
I know that there are millions of people better than me.
Mm-hmm.
But what I can do is work on myself. How can I get better each day? And I believe that's the key to real success as a teacher.
Yep.
How can I be better every day? How can I help my kids be better every day? And these little marginal gains. And I think that's what it's all about.
And how do you do that, Fladlien? Because, you know, you've been teaching for 31 years. It's such a long time. And if I do something, I'll get tired of it, you know what I mean? How do you keep that passion alive, and how do you keep bettering yourself?
I like to drink a lot of caffeine. many a times I go home and I feel beat down.
Mm-hmm.
And you just got to say that tomorrow's another day.
Right.
And I just got to believe, and I hate to do this to you because this isn't what you expect. I believe that's what makes you so pretty, is that belief in the spirit that shines through your eyes, that humans are good, that humans do want to do something. And I believe in that spirit, that every man is good, that every man can achieve something, and that means woman too.